Please do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. Welcome to episode 9 of Ramayana for Children. Let's have a quick recap of what happened last week and proceed to today's chapter. Kumbhakarna enters the battlefield on behalf of Ravana. He is, however, killed by Rama. Next, Ravana's three sons enter the battlefield too and are also killed. Lakshmana is injured. After a fierce and long battle, Ravana's son Atikaya was killed. When his mother Danyamalini heard of her son's death, she wept bitterly. Ravana was also very sad and disappointed. Then Indrajit talked to Ravana and convinced him that he would avenge his brother's death in the battlefield the next day. The brave Indrajit went into battle. Rama sent Lakshmana to face Indrajit. The monkey army was quite disturbed by Indrajit's arrival. With a deafening roar, he caught both Rama and Lakshmana in the Nagapasha or noose of serpents. Sugriva and the others were distraught at the sight. The gods in heaven protested. They were restless and confused. Filled with pride at such an easy walkover, Indrajit returned to the palace. Then Hanuman approached Garuda, the vehicle of Vishnu, and prayed to him to devour the snakes and free Rama and Lakshmana. As snakes were Garuda's staple diet, he quickly flew to the battlefield and freed them from the Nagapasha. Rama thanked Garuda sincerely. When Indrajit heard that Rama and Lakshmana had been freed from the Nagapasha, he flew into a rage. With huge, angry steps, he marched back to the battlefield and challenged Rama and Lakshmana once again. After seeking Rama's permission, Lakshmana attacked the brave Indrajit and they fought a mighty duel. When Indrajit realized that he alone would not be able to overpower Lakshmana and was being pushed towards defeat, he used Shakti, the mighty weapon, on Lakshmana. Immediately, Lakshmana fell down, unconscious. Indrajit tried his best to lift his mighty rival Lakshmana in his arms, but he could not do so. Embarrassed, he left the battlefield. When Hanuman realized that Lakshmana had fainted, he lifted him on his shoulders and took him to Rama. When Rama saw Lakshmana in such a state, he cradled his young brother in his lap and cried loudly. The army of monkeys was plunged in sorrow and despair. Vibhishana consoled Rama and told him to fetch Sushena, the physician, from Lanka to treat Lakshmana. In the stealth of the night, Hanuman went to Lanka and brought back Sushena with him. The physician examined Lakshmana and said that there was a herb, the Sanjeevani Bhuti, that could revive him, but it grew only on the peak of a mountain in the Himalayas. But if Hanuman did not return with the Sanjeevani Bhuti before sunrise, chances were that Lakshmana would not survive the power of Shakti, the weapon that had felled him. After seeking Rama's permission, Hanuman traversed to the Himalayas. When Ravana learned from his wife that Hanuman was on his way to fetch the Sanjeevani Bhuti from the Himalayas, he went to the magician Kalneni and told him to use his magical powers to halt Hanuman on his way to the Himalayas and kill him through deceit. Kalneni set about obeying Ravana's orders. At night, on the Dronagiri mountain in the Himalayas, all herbs looked alike. Hanuman could not recognize the Sanjeevani Bhuti, so he lifted the entire Dronagiri mountain and flew back to Lanka. As Hanuman flew over Ayodhya, Bharata at Nandigram mistook him for a Rakshasa and fired a featherless arrow at him. Hanuman cried out, "Sri Rama," and fell to the ground. When Bharata heard him take the name of Rama, he came close to him. He was deeply saddened after hearing the entire story of the battle. He made Hanuman sit on his swiftest arrow and sent him off to Lanka. Hanuman was back before sunrise. With the Sanjeevani Bhuti, Sushena revived Lakshmana. The army of monkeys was overjoyed to see their beloved Lakshmana healthy again. When Indrajit received the news of Lakshmana's survival, he decided to pray to Ishtadevi in her cave to seek the boon of invisibility. Vibhishana told Rama that if Indrajit succeeded in conducting this yajna, he would become invincible. Rama sent Angada and the other monkeys to disrupt the yajna, thus saving the day.